see a fluffy white cloud in the sky, depending where you are, it could be made of bird poop. Well, kinda. I'm Anna, and this is Gross Science. To understand how bird poop could make clouds, you first need to know a little something about how clouds form. So clouds form when water evaporates from oceans, lakes, and other reservoirs, or is released from plants in a process called transpiration. The water is in a gaseous form called water vapor, and it floats up into the atmosphere. Now, the vapor could just hang out in the air unseen, but in order to become a cloud, the water has to cool and attach itself to something we call a condensation nucleus. Dust particles, ice crystals, specks of pollution, and even fungal spores can all serve as condensation nuclei. Water molecules glom onto them, becoming water droplets. And when this is repeated over and over again, we can see these droplets in the form of clouds. So what does this have to do with bird poop? Well, bird poop is really rich in nitrogen, and we've known this for years. Beginning centuries ago, people would actually mine guano, which is a fancy term for the accumulated poop of seabirds or bats, and they'd use it as fertilizer because nitrogen helps plants grow. But humans aren't the only creatures with an affection for guano. Bacteria love it too. Bacteria chow down on the guano and release a nitrogen-based molecule called ammonia as a waste product. And given that tens of millions of seabirds spend their summers in the Arctic, bacteria there produce a ton of ammonia, about 40,000 metric tons each year, to be exact. When the ammonia drifts up into the atmosphere, it reacts with sulfuric acid and water. And when other molecules in the air latch on, it becomes a condensation nucleus, adding to the total number of these guys floating around above the Arctic. Now, you know how clouds can either look bright or dark? Well, that's due to the size and number of droplets they're made of. Here are two clouds, each in an environment with the same amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. The bright one is made of a large number of small droplets, while the dark one is made of a small number of large droplets. In the bright cloud, the water's just divided among more condensation nuclei. Now, there's still a lot we don't understand about how clouds affect climate, but we do know that bright clouds help reflect sunlight away from Earth, which means that they can have a cooling effect on our planet. And that means that all the additional droplets contributed by the ammonia from Arctic bird poop could be helping to keep our planet a little bit cooler. The effects are likely not huge, but as Greg Wentworth, a scientist involved with the study, told me, the birds make a relatively small, yet smelly, contribution. For me, this study brings home the importance of basic research, both on clouds, but also on seabird biology. Now that we know bird poop may be part of our climate story, it's more important than ever for us to study and protect them. So, all you future scientists out there, I hope you're feeling inspired. And maybe just a little grossed out. Ew. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have a question about bird poop and clouds, let me know in the comments. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.